I think we've all felt that fear at one point or another. We feel ourselves getting older, time passing. We want to work hard and find success, but we also want to enjoy our youth and have fun. I've always felt a little bit afraid of not being able to maintain a balance between the two. At the beginning of 2023, my friends Jack and I started our own business, and believe it or not, it actually takes a lot of work to get one of those things going in the beginning. I wanted to start off 2023 strong with the business, and honestly, the first half of the year, I didn't have the healthiest balance of work and play. Jack and I were trying to juggle being full-time students and starting a business with very little experience in that realm, and by the end of the school year, we were just totally burnt out. Neither one of us really had any interest in going outside and just going camping and going hiking and filming those experiences because we were so focused on filming for work. After starting out the first 3 weeks of summer working almost all day every day, we decided it was time for a change of pace. Both of us have always dreamed of doing a huge cross-country road trip with our friends, and I think both of us would die regretting not having done it. It made the most sense financially to stay in Virginia for the summer and keep working and taking small breaks, but part of us felt like if we don't do this now, we might never. You can probably guess what happened next.
We have to spread out the word.
How'd we do?
Starting route from Virginia to Banff.
And just like that, we were on the road to Colorado. But let's not get too ahead of ourselves here. First, we had to clear the Midwest.
How boring is it? You know how boring Kansas is? They named their counties by numbers.
Fast forward 1,700 painful miles through the Midwest and Kansas, we finally made it to our first stop, Rocky Mountain National Park. To start off the trip, we actually got to meet up with our Michigan buddy, Mr. Brendan Zion, the runner guy. He was out in Denver this summer training for the Leadville 100, a crazy difficult ultramarathon, and we were lucky enough to link up with him for Alpenglow. Big shout out to you, Mr. Brendan.
Did a lot yesterday because I got really mad that I lost my sunglasses again, so I was just cranking them out.
You did 500.
I did like 150 and then like 50 dips or something.
So yes, as I mentioned, I have a terrible habit of losing my sunglasses, and here's the trail that I did that on. We also got to meet up with our close friend from home in Virginia, Miss Megan Shantz, who is actually capable of doing, I think, 40 push-ups in one set. Something crazy like that. I don't even know, but shout out to you, Megan. Hey. You're awesome.
Look at this absolute stud of a human being.
Dude, Megan did 40.
Yeah, what the hell?
Yeah.
like sick sunset, and this guy comes up to us, and he's like, what are y'all looking at? Why are y'all looking at that? What's up?
Why are you looking at that?
Yeah, he's like, what are you, like, why are you looking at this? After we explored Rocky Mountain National Park, we got a little bit hungry, so we went to look for a spot to cook. All right, Nick, what are we doing? Got the gear.
We're gonna cook, baby.
We're going up there.
That rock looks over there.
Let's go to it.
Sometimes when you see the right rock, I think you just know it. And this was one of those moments where we just knew we need to go up to that thing and cook on it.
This rock sliding down.
Really? Oh, we're moving. Look at this view behind us. Only up from here is this.
That's not awesome.
What?
I think we should pick a flat rock.
Yeah.
Like that one.
Okay.
This one's cool. It's too steep though. You know?
Yeah.
We should go right there. Same view.
Okay.
All right, bro, let's do it.
Dude, we got up quick.
Yeah, let's take a breather.
Oh my god.
That's beautiful.
That is sick. Chef Mattavelli doing his thing. Cook it up. How's she feeling? Looks ready.
Oh, she ready.
She ready. Let's go.
Oh, that sound.
Looking good. We got our 5-star meal. $2 pasta sauce.
Nick and I got to eat our gourmet pasta with this sweet view, and then we got ready to head to our next stop, Wyoming.
Hello.
The next day, we had about a 7-hour drive to Wind River, Wyoming, and it was one of the most beautiful drives we've ever experienced, honestly, and we were just vibing. So here's a few clips from that.
Nick, you're rocking the hat, bro.
Ah, dude, this is an awesome hat.
The golden hour was just amazing, and once the light started hitting those peaks, we were freaking out a little bit.
This is insanity! So many fish! Oh!
According to a few different sources, Wind River, Wyoming is actually the most remote place you can go to in the entire lower 48. And we were in for a few adventures here.
Oh my god.
What?
There's the boys. God.
Dude, like, look at that.
The reflection.
The reflection is glowing more than the actual.
I know. Oh my God. Yo!
Than anything I ever.
This is the beginning of Alpenglow Media.
Nobody even knows about our name yet.
Exactly. Let's go.
Do you think that we're about to like walk?
Absolute. On which rock?
I get my 23
okay. Four.
I'm just on my
board. Yep.
Standing on the
corner. Oh shit. In a phone.
Hey, did you get?
Dude, I got it.
Oh, okay. I'm catching on me.
There on the corner is where you'll hear me sing. But only the greatest bouncer. Alright, Mr. Skipper. That was pretty good.
The Virginia rocks are better, that's what.
Oh, I'll tell you. Way flatter.
The rocks are like getting in my shoes.
We got Nick skipping rocks.
Different.
These dudes doing God knows what.
Music.
Mr. Drone right here.
Mr. Drone the
we
baby.
Just recently got him doing video. Now he's the drone guy.
I'm still doing photos.
Well, look at that. Oh, you're doing photos. Mr. Tamron. Let's see. Shout out Tamron. Mm.
You know it.
Yeah. Blue Hour Tamron. Yeah. We're all wearing blue.
We're in Tamron legend, bro.
Everyone's wearing blue. It's Blue Hour.
Blue Hour.
Blue Hour, brother.
Ow, ow, ow. So
great. Yeah, Jack's stuff is insane. Yeah, I'm getting you filming her photo. I'll let you take my pride. Who needs it anyway? There's nothing to hide. That's why I'll let you push all of my buttons all the time. I'll let you push all of my buttons.
My heart was just like. I heard a noise and I was like, fuck this, I'm going back.
Back to bed.
I saw Austin shooting last night.
Yeah, you did. He kept shining the light on me.
Push me off the edge, so you like.
After about a 5 mile hike into the backcountry, we prepared for the coldest polar plunge of our lives.
The Hoka phone shot.
2K23.
There you go.
We just get.
Look at Chris compared. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Dude, that was so funny. That was so funny. The difference.
So, despite Chris seemingly not feeling a thing, that was some of the coldest water we've ever been in.
That shit was.
It was straight up glacier melt, and the adrenaline rush was just insane jumping in there. But it was worth it, and it was fun.
That was so funny.
Look me in the eye and tell me you love me. I am your I, says he. I hope that you see each other in each other. I hope that you'll be the I.
So those clips are actually some of my favorites I've ever taken, and we actually had our worst night of sleep of all time the night before. We slept sitting up in my Honda, four of us in one car with all of our stuff in there, and it was just extremely hard to sleep, but that's just a sacrifice you've got to make sometimes when you're on the road trying to catch the sunrise, and we did, so it was all worth it.
God, you can see the diseases on the lake.
Tamron.
On these trips, it's always a balance of filming enough and getting all the content and just enjoying the experience and taking it all in. So for the rest of the day this day, I just put my camera away for most of it. We ended up doing this really cool hike called Delta Lake Trail, and here's a quick iPhone clip from that. Oh my golly.
Yeah.
Boys, what are we thinking?
It's the grandest of all peaks.
Oh my god. So that peak there you just saw was actually the Grand Teton, which is pretty cool. It was really awesome seeing that thing in person, and I'm honestly glad that I wasn't using my camera much during the day just so I could experience it more and fully take it in. I didn't film really at all on that hike, but by the end of the day, the sunset was looking so nice, I had to break out my camera and film some clips. I know that contradicts the entire idea of not filming everything and experiencing it all and being present, but I just can't help myself sometimes.
Falling. Dreaming, talking in your sleep. I know you want to cry all night. All night. Plotting,
scheming.
What shot? Oh my god, I got it. I'm on it.
Reason to defend all of your violent nights. Promise me.
Oh, what you need to do. Okay, wait, let me find a place to sit.
See right here?
All
right. And then just hold the camera steady. I'm just going to chill and just put it down right there. Just like that.
Boom.
All right. Just hold it steady. Fuck, I need to make it more natural. You ready?
Wait. All right, ready. Wait, do that one more time.
Is that like, it needs to be like just centered, just like that.
Chris, where are we today? You know, in the Tetons. Ripping some shots of our boy. The real deal is Nick. Focus. Lucky were we, like, we saw him and then he went perfectly into the composition that we were getting.
Walking out when he was.
Chris, was that your bucket shot right there?
Yeah.
Like, maybe the coolest road shot in the Tetons ever. And then the coolest animal walks through.
Can you believe it? I can. I'm still in disbelief.
Once again, we need a bear.
Yeah, no, you're right.
Coming out the woods.
We can still one up it.
Like, slashing its artery open.
Yeah. Blood everywhere.
Yeah, it's like animal.
Hangs on the wall.
Put the antlers on the car after.
That's
oh,
the front.
And then we go back to Virginia with him just sitting up there.
We'll put its tail on the
and then like a Rudolph nose in the front of the car.
No.
Oh my god.
Oh, he's going between them.
That's so fucking cool. We ended up driving through Yellowstone on the way up to Glacier, but we ended up only staying about a day, even though it was absolutely beautiful because there were so many mosquitoes. And it was also super touristy.
The reason to ponder while we get obliterated by mosquito.
A little bit touristy too, eh?
That's a geyser.
Oh.
So that's our new friend Kaylee swimming in the water there, and I wanted to give her a shout out because she skipped work for multiple days to come up to Glacier with us after we met up with her in the Tetons, and she literally jumped in every alpine lake we went to despite how cold they were. So yeah, that was insanely cool, and we had a blast hanging out with you.
That's insane.
So right about now is when we thought the trip might have actually come to an end. The car was making some pretty crazy noises, and we were supposed to get up to Canada next, but we weren't sure that was going to happen at this point. We were in a little bit of a pickle here because we weren't going to be able to get our car serviced for two more days, so we spent most of the next day just hanging out at Flathead Lake, which is outside of Glacier National Park. What happened next was pretty insane. We spent the night broken down in this little parking lot right here, and super early in the morning this guy comes who works like for the park area, I guess, and he kicked us out, so we had to roll the Honda, and I mean roll, about 10 miles into town and just wait at the car servicing place until it opened. But the next part that was actually insane, so we bring the car in to get serviced and we find out that the power steering was basically gone, and that was making the noises we heard. But one of my tires was also completely shot and our brake pads were pretty messed up, so they ended up fixing all these problems for us and evaluating the entire car for $30. So I don't know if the guy just felt bad for us and he saw that we were a bunch of young broke kids and wanted to help us out, but he saved us big time. So after we left, we drove straight to Krispy Kreme and got the entire team 2 dozen donuts as a thank you. Thanks again, guys. You saved us and we were able to make it to Canada because of you. After this super peaceful morning at the lake, we ended up doing the hardest hike I think I've ever done in terms of elevation gain. It was over 5,000 feet of elevation gain in just a few miles, so it was so steep and we were getting crushed, but the views were absolutely insane. This was one of those climbs that you probably don't want to send your mom videos of because you'll freak her out so much. So, mom, if you're seeing this, I apologize.
Keep it down low like you're in Kung Fu Panda.
All right, ready when you are, sir.
That's so tough. No, it needs to be slower.
This place is so rugged that I feel like it speaks for itself. So I'm gonna relax on the narration for a few and just roll some clips.
Is that some Floyd Pink? It is. Think about how nice the way down can be.
Oh my god.
Wow, dude, we've seen so much elevation. Oh, wow, we have like. Dude, I'd much rather that.
Fucking
wine
for
9 miles.
I agree. I think we're going to that cliff over there.
Where that water
is. That provides water.
Austin, you got a picture of me looking super sexy.
Oh, of course. Vamos.
Oh my god.
Oh my golly.
Yo, this water's leaking all over my ass.
No. No.
The worst way to go.
Rest of the boys are up there. This is so sick. No!
So yeah, the hike down was pretty sketch, but we made it and we finished the hike safely. We only had a couple days left on the trip and we spent the entire next day exploring Yoho National Park.
Not something I've really heard much about.
So at this point of the trip, it had been about 3 weeks since I'd seen my girlfriend Riley, and I was about to lose my damn mind from missing her so much. So I just sat on this rock for like an hour calling her, and just pretty much pretended she was sitting there next to me looking at the views. Yeah, it's pretty rough traveling without your significant other because you miss them so much, but we're gonna do our own road trip soon, so stay tuned. Osrai road trip 2024.
Like... go, go!
Ah! You're so fast.
Chacos. You.
She's going into oncoming traffic. Oh my god.
We spent our last evening in Canada before heading home, just relaxing, and we got ready to climb up a mountain to an alpine tea house the next day.
Best tea of your life?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Mm-mm.
Like, nothing. Absolutely.
When we got to the tea house, one of the funniest experiences of the whole trip happened. When Nick ordered his tea, he asked them if they had ice, which clearly they didn't because they had to helicopter all their supplies in and they had no electricity, but the way the lady looked at him when he asked that was so funny.
This is nature's Yeti.
Y'all got ice here?
Y'all got ice.
I read the sign and it said no electricity, no ice.
And it said water flown in by helicopter. Yeah. No, I was not joking. It said that.
This hike was the perfect end to the trip. After 3 weeks of being on the road, our trip was finally coming to a close. The trip had its ups and downs, like everything in life, but it was an experience of a lifetime, and I'll never forget it. We're only young for so long, and our friends are only around for so long, too. So get out and go make some memories. Have fun. Enjoy yourself. Do the things. Do all the things. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. So there's an actual trail here. We followed it all the way this way, and then we get to the fork right here and had to traverse across this shit at like a 70 degree angle. Yeah, we're alive though.
We had a bag of food that we bought at the store. I was throwing trash away and I threw the bag of food away thinking it was trash. So we're going to get it out of the trash at McDonald's.
Amazing.
Follow me.
I'll walk you through it.
Walk me there.